not got this person and da da da. They kind of do watch it. They, you know, they don't let on to it. But we're a drama. We have to change. We have to do different things to keep ourselves current. And also, if we didn't do that, we'd be boring.
What is you're Scottish and you spend a lot of time in America. That's why we've got the American accent.
If you really want me to, I can speak in a Scottish accent.
This is especially for Jackie. Jackie says, Foley, when Captain Jack comes in, would you get him to speak in his sexy, goddamn Scottish accent, please?
No problem. You see, for you, JP. I'm going to come over there and snog him in a minute.
I must respectfully decline.
Is there a webcam
kiss
there?
An immortal action hero.
I'm very hairy. I'll give you a beard burn, you know?
There's nothing wrong with hair. You're hairy. I'm smooth.
This is all good
together.
This is awkward. Yeah.
Is it awkward?
Yeah, it's very awkward.
Do you want to leave the room?
It's almost like it's just a two-way thing.
I'll kiss you too.
I'm okay. I'm actually okay. Thank you.
You're all right?
Yeah.
Whatever action I can get, I'll take it.
Of course, you're doing a load of other stuff as well. Sylvia's one. She says, Ray, I just found out John Barrowman is on your show. My sister Audrey loves him. She cries for the full duration of a show when it's on Saturdays. We're in fits laughing at her. Like, I'm talking from the credits on, she's a bag of tears. It's so funny.
Well, I think you might want to take her to see somebody about that. No, I love that. The fact is that Tonight's the Night is a show where I'm, you know, people might think this is cheesy. I don't care. This is the truth. I'm living a dream that I always dreamt about as a kid. I'm doing what I love to do. I enjoy going to work every day, and it's exciting for me to be able to make other people's dreams come true or give them that kind of the accolade that they deserve because they're a good person or because they deserve something nice to happen to them. If that's her reaction, then we've done our job, and I love Tonight's the Night and love what it stands for.
You've got a cookbook and two autobiographies.
This is funny because the cookbook actually was a gift from my niece that she made for our family last Christmas, and I asked her if I could adapt it and sell it.
Make a quick book off your niece.
I'm giving the most of the proceeds to her to help her start herself in her new new life and relationship kind of thing. We just printed off a 1,500 copies. They're selling like hotcakes. I can't believe it. You know, Jamie Oliver, watch out. I've got the cookbook out, the family cookbook.
I was reading a cookbook the other day, and there's a recipe for beans and toast in it.
Seriously. See, that's silly.
I mean, that's what it's gotten to.
Check out mine, because there's some really good recipes in there, and quick ones, and also the fact, if you like desserts...
What's your niece's name?
My niece's name is Claire. Claire. Named after County Clare.
Claire's loving this. Claire's loving this plug for your cookbook.
Of course she is. Hopefully this will help her out.
Is she actually named after County Clare?
Yeah, she is, because my grandfather was from County Clare. His name was Andrew Butler, and in fact, I was saying to my business partner, we have a production company together, Barrowman Barker Productions. I'd love to do a research program going back to find out my Irish roots, because obviously my Scottish roots I know to a certain extent, but it would be great to find out both of the Celtic roots and how they came together.
The BBC will pay for that. Who do you think you are?
Well, you know, I might want to do it with somebody else. You never know.
Make a phone call; they'll pay you for it.
Yeah, we'll see.
We have an Irish one as well on RTE. We'll do it over here.
Yes, if there's an Irish link, they'll put you on the RTE one.
There you go.
Our local one.
Because, well, my family lineage is from County Clare.
And then you've got two autobiographies.
Yes.
Because that's because you've had two lives.
I have, actually.
Yeah.
Yes.
What's the other one?
One is Captain Jack, one is John Barrowman. So, no, they're not really both autobiographies. The first one is an autobiography. And when I was approached to write it by Michael O'Mara Books, I actually said to them, are you crazy? I'm not that old. Even though I am.
You are. You're very
92.
Old. You are 92.
Yes.
Yeah. Remarkably well preserved for 92. Captain Jack. This is why they picked him for the role of Captain Jack, because he's really old. He wasn't running for World War One.
The first book is an autobiography of up to my kind of Captain Jack phase, and then it went into the Sunday Times bestseller list, and they approached me again and said, can you write another one? I said, well, I haven't done very much since the last one, so why don't I go back? I asked the fans what they would like, and they wanted more family stories, so we went back, and my sister and I then got all family stories together that we didn't put in the other book, and put a book together of kind of the fans' questions, what the fans liked, okay. stories from them, how the last autobiography had changed their lives, and certain things that I've done, and then related it to stories, excuse me, in my life. So it was a nice book to do. Mm. But I do have another book coming out in February.
Another one?
Not about me. Right, okay. My sister and I have written a series of fantasy and science fiction kind of esque books for young teens about a brother and sister team who have some special powers, and it's all set in Scotland. Okay. So it's quite good.
Do you ever sit still?
No, never. Even when I'm sitting here, my knee's going.
In your knee? That's because of JP, though.
I know.
That's the JP effect.
That's what happens, you know. That's what I bring to the show. My hot blondness.
And hairiness.
And hair. Your hot blonde hairiness.
Yeah, I know.
You're hairy and it's okay. What was the line you said a minute ago?
He's hairy, I'm smooth.
We go together like ebony and ivory.
We go together like...
Oh, no.
Barrowman is singing to me.
Hair and smooth.
It's been a pleasure to meet you.
It's been great to be here. Thank you for having me on.
Thanks for coming on. We're sorry to hear that you've got a sore back. We were going to play...
Listen, the pain's gone. You guys have got the pain. Thanks for the massage, JP, earlier.
No problem. No problem. Deep tissue massage.
Yeah. I was wondering why he brought in his massage table today.
Really?
And the oil, the baby oil. But
he didn't put me on a massage table.
Did he?
No. I meant to go on the massage table?
Completely different location.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's an alternative technique I've been working on.
Hotel next door? Why did you do that, JP? Do you have a girlfriend, JP?
I'm working on it.
Well, you're not now. All the boys are going to be hitting on you.
I've got things in the pipeline. Still,
I'm loving this.
He is in his element right now.
This is brilliant.
Hit on him.
You've provided exactly what we needed on the show today, John.
All my fellow boys out there in Dublin, hit on JP.
John is thrusting his hips on his chair as he says it. This man is pure filth, honestly.
John Barrowman is live in the Grand Canal Theatre in Dublin on Thursday. We're conscious of the fact that you have to leave. We wish you...
No, keep talking. They're not pulling me away yet.
They are. They're pulling away. They're pulling away. We hate that. Grand Canal Theatre in Dublin on Thursday the 10th of November. Are you only doing the one night? Is there going to be one of these situations where all of a sudden they announce another night?
No. It's only one night because this is my first time performing in Dublin for about 14 years. I did a show at the Olympia Theatre, Aspects of Love, years ago. But now this is my first solo performance. So we only do the one night, and then when we do a tour, hopefully next year, we'll be back and we'll do two or more. It's kind of what happened. Like in Manchester, the band was so big after the last one. We now do two nights, same in Birmingham, two nights. So
you've been working for years, though. I mean, JP and I were talking about this earlier, that we knew you off the telly from years ago.
From Live and Kicking?
Yes.
Children's Television.
From Live and Kicking.
Then you disappeared. Did you go back over to America?
I didn't disappear. I did Live and Kicking, then did the movie game. Then I went off and just focused on and did theater. I did more kind of West End. I did a couple of TV shows in the States. But then I came back and did some more theater. And then it was Captain Jack that kind of turned things around for me, but I still do. I have my own children's TV show that you may not know of. It's called Animals at Work, and it's on CBBC. So I still keep my hand in to, you know, entertain the young ones. And it's a really kind of fun show about animals that have jobs, like elephants that paint and squirrels that do obstacle courses with the military and stuff. It's really, really quite fun.
You are a gazillionaire. You're working so
you are a gazillionaire. He's still winking
JP,
at me.
Stick with
best
me.
Interview
you
ever.
Live a really comfortable life.
The best
smooth
life.
And hairy.
The best
really
life.
Will.
Yeah. I'd be like Pretty Woman. Julia Roberts and Pretty Woman.
I'd make sure you drove around in a really nice car, though.
JP, I'm not kidding.
Don't you worry, JP.
You should really consider this.
I'm going to leave.
This is the best offer you've ever had.
Yeah. I'm going to join the circus. I'm going with John.
That's fine. I own a circus.
Yeah.
He will say anything.
You could be in the circus with John acting in the trapeze and everything, and it'd be amazing. He can give you, I can't give you what he can give you, JP.
It's true.
You should consider it. Seriously.
My dreams have come true.
JP's looking at the clock going, we're out of here now.
time, please.
Grand Canal Theatre Dublin, Thursday the 10th of November 2011. He's also in the Belfast Waterfront Theatre on the 9th, the night before, on the 9th of November. So that's the 9th in Belfast, the 10th of November in Dublin, the Grand Canal Theatre.
And if you see me driving down, because my van that I tour in, I call it Barry Vanilo.
Right. Okay.
It's awesome. It's big and it's white and it's got big stripes down it, and it's fantastic. So if you give us a wave.
Or a beep.
Or a beep.
And you'll see JP in the passenger seat.
Absolutely. Yeah. Singing
Copacabana. JP will be in the back.
I was thinking he'd be riding shotgun, but I...
Don't say that.
Handcuffed to the chair in the back.
S-S-S-M-M-M. Cracking Loud Theatre Dublin, 10th of November. John Barrowman. We love him!
Thank you. I knew it wasn't the singing that got it for me. It wasn't the acting. It wasn't the triathlons. It wasn't the box. It wasn't Eurostar. It was all of them put together, buddy.
It was the outstanding bit. That's what it is. And are you looking forward to Friday?
They couldn't think of an award to give me, so they just went giving the outstanding one. If you want to see me in the flesh, get into the Olympia from the 14th to the 26th of November. Don't worry about weekends. They're already taken care of. Get in on the Monday or Tuesday.
From one comedy great to another. Thank you very much.
See
you
later.
The Ian Dempsey Breakfast Show with Renault. Drive the change. At AXA, we've reduced our car insurance prices by up to 15%. That's one reason why more people in Ireland choose to insure with AXA than any other insurance company. And you can talk to us day or night, all year round. So for great cover at a great price, drop into your local branch, visit AXA.ie or call us on 1890 247 365. AXA, redefining standards. Terms and conditions apply. Prices have been reduced by up to 15% compared to June 2011. AXA Insurance Limited is regulated by the Central Bank of Ireland.
Is it a burger? Is it a plane? No, it's Super Saver. Flying to a Supermax near you.